As the summer travel season gets into full swing, you may find yourself traveling to vulnerable places in the height of the season. So what can you do to keep you and your family safe? Well, Jonathan Nichols, Vice President of Underwriting for WorldTrips, joins us now to talk about the importance of travel insurance. Jonathan, thanks so much for joining us. Really an important topic, right? So let's get into it. What exactly does travel insurance cover?
Well, thanks, Janet. Thanks, Alex. Yeah, it's great to be here again. Travel insurance is really designed to cover those risks that a traveler takes for unforeseen cancellations before the trip, or if something bad were to happen during the trip. Travel insurance is designed to protect the traveler in that case. So whether that means a hurricane is coming and you need to cancel your trip, or a hurricane arrives during your trip, and you need to interrupt and go home early.
So what should you look for when purchasing travel insurance, and how early into the planning process do you need to buy it?
Ideally, the customer buys it as soon as they book their trip. Once you put your credit card information in and you put that deposit down or you book that vacation rental, immediately go and start looking for travel insurance. It's never too early to buy. The message really is buy early, as early as possible. Once a storm is named, there's no coverage for that storm. So if your concern is a tropical storm or a hurricane, you'll want to buy as early as possible.
So what is the most common misconception about travel insurance? What do people kind of not quite understand about travel insurance?
I think people think that it really just is intended to cover everything that could possibly happen, and that's simply not realistic. There are ways to get more coverage. We advise our customers often to go look for on our WorldTrips.com website or other sites out there, look for a cancel for any reason policy if they're looking for the broadest available coverage. But I think what trips a lot of customers up is they expect that certain things are covered, that all situations would be covered, and they're just not. Like I said, for those customers who want the broadest possible coverage, cancel for any reason is their best bet.
Do you have to buy that cancel for any reason coverage? You have to buy that within a certain amount of time of purchasing your trip?
Typically, that needs to be purchased within a certain amount of time. Different companies do it differently. We've seen some that say you have to buy it as soon as you book your trip. Others are a little bit more flexible, maybe 21, 30 days after booking. But again, it's a time-limited coverage, and it is something that we recommend customers buy early.
And I'm assuming that the sort of cancel anytime coverage, that's going to be a little bit more pricier. That's my assumption, at least.
Yeah, that's a great assumption. Yes, it is a little bit more expensive. But again, for those customers who want those, extra 20% reasons that customers cancel, if you're worried about a storm, probably don't need it. If you're worried about your pet getting sick, maybe you do. But yes, it does carry an extra cost with it. And that could be anywhere between, say, 25 and 50%.
Is there any difference, whether it's domestic or international, in terms of how you purchase travel insurance?
No, the process is still the same. For international, you might be booking a little bit further in advance than you do for a domestic trip, but the process is still the same. Most insurance companies sell both. The coverages might be a little bit bigger for international travel. We find our customers need more medical coverage when they're traveling out of the country. So there may be some small differences in what the customer is looking for, what their comfort level is with things like emergency evacuation coverage or medical coverage, but the process is still the same.